Disinfect, my nigga. I can't even listen to no more. But I gotta show love for the homie Scott Eric, you know what I'm saying? Dropping the big 1999 in the building and then back doing a whole 999. And then Brandon Tillery ain't playing no game with a whole $5. Then Taylor Ray back though the whole 499. But I'm gonna tell you why we here. I know y'all probably saw it. Beto, yeah, I saw your little interview. Yeah. Like them hoes say, I saw your little interview on the Donnie Houston show. You know what I'm saying? And then Jesus Trevino backed up a whole 499. But this where it gets sticky at. I don't like that shit. I don't like that shit. Cause he ain't telling it like it is. Yeah.
Let's go.
I'm here to set the record straight. Huh? I'm here to set the record straight. Cause a lot of y'all don't know. When Beto was producing them beats, when he was producing them songs, I was right there. And I say, boys didn't know that we had our bread up. Hit that button right there, Beto. And he hit that button. And that shit started jamming like a motherfucker. I say, Beto, I'm going to sell a CD in the street. But that's what you need to do. Hit that button right there.
Let's go.
And he took my lead. I say, hit that button right there. Not that one, Beto. Hit this one.
Come on.
Yeah. And he hit that one. And when I came back off the streets selling CD, He had some bangers. I wasn't thinking nothing of it, though. You see what I'm saying? But time progressed, and then he have another idea. Gorillas in my trunk. Ain't nobody out basing me. You know what I mean? So I say, Beto, hit that button right there.
Let's go.
And then hit that button right. I say, matter of fact, let me hit it. Then I hit this one. And then we produce Gorillas in My Trunk. Ain't nobody out basing me. Yeah. Yeah. So the next song, he say, I see your big player partner out there in the streets. You be grinding hard. I say, grind hard. You know what I'm saying? Grind hard. He say, hold up. And we went back in the studio. And I say, Beto, hit that button right there.
Let's go.
And then I hit this button.
Come on.
Then I say, Beto, hit that button right there. Not that one, Beto, this one.
Come on.
And then we produce Grind Hard. Get it straight. Fuck them 20s and 10s. Grind hard. You see what I'm saying? And I ain't never said nothing for 15 years. Like he just did. He ain't say nothing for 15 years. It took him 15 years to come out. But I ain't say nothing. But then he pulled out the motherfucking platinum and gold plaques. And I went to feeling some kind of way. Because I ain't got one. I ain't got not one motherfucking gold platinum plaque on the wall when I'm the one who said hit that button.
Come on.
Hit that button. Hit that button.
Let's go.
Hit that button.
Come on.
So in actuality, I'm the co-producer. I'm the co-producer. You see what I'm saying? So when I seen him on Dine in Houston, I was feeling some kind of way. Because I was supposed to have been on that couch too. Sitting next to the platinum and gold plaque. I've been trying to call him, but he ain't picking up. So I thought, I know how to get to him. I thought, I know how to get to him like everybody else do. Go on the internet.
Come on, let's go.
So here I am, keeping it untrilled. I want to say, Beto, I saw your little interview on Donnie in Houston. You looking good, boy. But you left me behind, my nigga. I want one of them platinum plaques. Huh? I want a victory lap. I want a UGK plaque. What about the buttons I push?
Let's go.
What about the button?
Come on.
To be honest with you, I'm a motherfucking lie. I don't even know how to turn the keyboard on.
Come on, let's go.
Hey, Taylor Ray, that motherfucking $4.99 show make me feel good in the bitch. But be honest with y'all, I don't even know how to turn the keyboard on. Huh? I couldn't make a motherfucking beat. You know what I mean? Let me see. I might make one. Let me see. How did shit go? I'm like, grind hard. Grind hard. Gorillas in my trunk. Ain't nobody. I'm lying like a motherfucker. Man, look, man. Ain't no hate over here, man. All I want to say is, if y'all ain't went seen that motherfucking Donnie Houston interview with DJ Beto and T.O.E., y'all niggas are bullshitting. Nigga, I don't know how to make no fucking beats. I don't even desire to make beats. That's how stupid I am. I've been doing music for 20 years and never really wanted to make a beat. Nigga, this nigga putting on, nigga, for PA, nigga. This nigga putting on for Texas, nigga. I've been telling that nigga for years. Beto, say something. Beto like, nah, I ain't gonna say shit. I'ma just work. But then look what he did. And nigga got on that dime in Houston and went smooth over nigga's head like helicopters. I'm talking about that nigga propellers. Ooh, that nigga was talking that boss shit. That nigga was letting his nuts hang, talking that big boss music shit. And all I can say is this. I'm proud of you, young nigga. I'm proud of you. Because before I met you, I met one of your old school partners. I was at DMD Studio. And I forgot the homie name. I think his nickname was Chop or something. And that nigga was promoting you like a motherfucker. That nigga was promoting you so hard, I damn near got tired of hearing about it. But that nigga say, man, look, that nigga was shaking his cup. That nigga had a whole styrofoam cup of eyes. That nigga was shaking his cup. And all he kept saying was, shit, nigga, when my little partner get out of motherfucking music school, he gonna be a problem, nigga. Yeah, nigga, know what I'm saying? And they kept saying, no, I'm saying, shaking his cup.
Come on.
And I'm like, who you talking about? He like, my little partner. Nigga, I ain't Beto. I'm like, I ain't never heard of him. You know what I'm saying? He like, man, this nigga here, man, the truth. This nigga the motherfucking truth. In and out the motherfucking booth. So I'm like, okay, my nigga. I'm in this shit, so I'm going to bump into him one day. So one day I was going to Houston. One day I was going to Houston, and I was on my way back, and something told me to stop at this little convenience store on the way home. And I stopped at the convenience store, going to give me some McDonald's. It was destined that I went, you know what I mean, in that McDonald's. Because when I went in that McDonald's, I seen a young nigga, and nigga said, what's up, he's? I'm like, what's up, nigga? The nigga said, man, I'm Beto, man. I say, you Beto that Chop be talking about? He like, yeah. I say, man, look, good to meet you, man. Your big homie got love for you. Your big homie been promoting and talking you up like a motherfucker, nigga. I'm shit, nigga. The nigga talk so good about you, nigga. I can't wait to meet you, nigga. Let me hear the beats. We in McDonald's at the table. Nigga, let me hear the beat. They're like, man, we gonna fuck around, boom, 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 this and that, this and that. Long story short, he working, he doing shit. Young nigga, doing his thing in PA. Then pimps start putting together, this another jump to speed. Pimps start putting together the UGK posse. You see what I'm saying? Smoke D was Depp, Vicious, Bundy, and Corey Moe. And then I stepped on the scene. As a rapper, hustler extraordinaire, wearing many motherfucking hats. Never hating on nobody because I love the fact that our brother, who was a Texas icon, took it upon himself to try to help so many brothers. Now he done extended himself to me. You know what I mean? In whatever capacity it was, now he's extended himself to me. And while he's doing that, he's helping local producers in the city. Ava Rex, Beatmaster. You know what I mean? Then he start fooling with young Beto. Yeah, Beto and T.O.E., the underdogs. The level pimp was on, he didn't have to do none of that shit. The level pimp was on, he didn't have to fool with none of us. But he fooled with us because he was cool with us and he wanted to see niggas rise to another level. He wanted to show niggas how to catch fish so they could feed themselves, not just give a nigga a fish. You see what I'm saying? Then he started handing out the motherfucking UGK dickies. And he gave everybody one who was UGK posse, nigga. He bought T.O.E. to the studio, we doing a project called The Triangle. Nigga Riley B facilitating everything, making sure a pimp gonna show up. This is some shit I put together. trying to bridge the gap between Beaumont, Port Arthur, and Orange. I told young niggas to get the morale up, Pimp gonna come participate. And eventually he did, which he didn't have to do that shit. So the first song me, Pimp, and T.O.E. did was actually, I forgot. Y'all know nigga, you know, nah, hit and never miss. We did that shit in the doctor's office, nigga. Late at night in the white folks area. Pimp pulled up, him and T.O.E., and we sat there and we wrote these motherfucking verses. And he gave me that to put on the triangle. To give the boys morale. The golden triangle. Beaumont, Port Arthur, in Orange. Fucking with him. He didn't have to do that. This was a made man. $1 million nigga. Didn't have to spend no time with none of us. Could have kept on moving and kept on going high, 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 high. And said bye, 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 bye to us. But he didn't. He fucked with us. And he took Beto under his wing. And taught him all kind of industry shit. Producer shit. He gave us all some shit. If we get back in our mind and remember. This nigga blessed us all, man, to still eat to this day. So fuck no, nigga. I won't come to no goddamn internet with no thumbnail, my little brother feeling no kind of way. Only kind of way I'm feeling, nigga, is joyous and hey, celebratory. Because PA, we got a young producer that's a platinum motherfucking producer and a gold producer. What you ought to be doing is coming together with a motherfucking staff throwing this nigga a goddamn party. You know what I mean? Player made. Hold on, I see some soup off in this bitch. Yeah, break my train of thought with that goddamn soup. Shit, I'm on one right now, Taylor Ray. I'm on one right now. But like I'm saying, what you should be doing is coming together, putting together a goddamn crusade saying salute to this nigga, DJ Beto, young nigga. Platinum and gold plaques. That nigga bought, not only did UGK bring home platinum and gold plaques, now we got a young brother, another young brother, a producer, then bought home to the 409 platinum and gold plaques, nigga. You know what that mean? That ain't no everyday shit any nigga can accomplish. This nigga is latched on to work that sold 500,000 copies. And then another that sold 1 million that still will be going and going and going. The motherfuckers might reach diamond, nigga. R.I.P. to Pimp C, man. R.I.P. to Nipsey Hussle. But that young brother is a student of the game who, he wasn't in the street fucking around heavy doing all this dumb ass shit. The nigga was in the studio. The nigga was in school learning shit. This is not to discredit no kind of street cred, because you can't take street cred to the bank and get no motherfucking loan. Huh? You might got street cred. I got street cred. But bring that shit to the bank and say, let me get 100 racks. And they're going to be like, what's your credit score? Well, I got street credit. Get your dumb ass out of here, bitch. All that shit over with. All of those thinking, ooh, I'm in the street. That means get your motherfucking ass out them streets. The end result is the penitentiary or the graveyard. You got nothing else to prove to nobody. You know what I mean? That's why these days, boy, I laugh and, ooh, I have me, I show my teeth. Nigga, I got my belly out, nigga. Because I ain't got nothing to prove to no motherfucker. You want to prove something? Show how smart you are. Show how skilled you are. Elevate and become resourceful for yourself, your children, your family, and then your community. That's some gangster shit. What Pimp C did was gangster. He extended himself to all these individuals. He touched so many people in so many ways. And here it is, 15 years later. DJ Beto finally opened his mouth and told y'all what the business is. He ain't have a whole bunch of cosign. He ain't have a whole bunch of this and that. He ain't have a whole bunch of celebrity endorsement. He had his talent. He had his skill. He had the investment of going sit and learn and countless of hours of recording different artists, different songs. And when Pimp heard him, he saw the potential. And he gave him the game. And I wish Pimp could see this. And niggas sitting up there on Donnie Houston going over niggas' head like a motherfucking aeroplane. Nigga, that's platinum and gold plaques that nigga sitting there with. That nigga a certified motherfucking platinum and gold producer, man. That nigga got the single on Nipsey Hussle album, Rap Niggas. You know what I mean? Victory Lap, nigga, Rap Niggas. So, nah. I wouldn't dare come on this internet talking down on a nigga like that. Only thing I would do is talk my nigga up. Boys didn't know that we had our bread up. Yeah. And when we were rolling on that UGK posse shit, he always picked up the phone and told me, let me put you on some new technology. Let me put you on some new game. And you know what? I value that shit. Because ain't too many people give me a motherfucking thing. But the Trillcast do. Don't get me wrong. Hey, man, I appreciate y'all. I ain't going to bullshit you, man. I appreciate y'all. But on this industry shit, anything and everything, niggas make me go find it. You know what I mean? Niggas make me scratching and claw for it. And I ain't got no problem with that. Because at the end of the day, when I discover and I find it, I did it. And I don't owe a motherfucker nothing. You don't know how good it feel to be a Trill nigga in Trill 1022. Still relevant. Music still, somebody appreciating. Create something and somebody still appreciating. Go live on YouTube. Trey Shift, go live on YouTube and somebody still appreciating. Most niggas my age, sitting in a rocking chair, dozing off. Most niggas my age got their grandchildren massaging their ankles because they got gout. Most niggas my age arguing with a bitch right now about the bills. Most niggas my age don't even know how to work the motherfucking internet. And I'm sitting up here 15 years later getting love. Look at that goddamn soup. $9.99 from Taylor Ray. Fuck you talking about. Shit, nigga. Nigga, I'm blessed in the motherfucker. And I wish Pimp could see that, man. I wish Pimp could see all of us, how we continue to represent and keep our head up and keep our stride. We didn't have a whole lot of industry favor, man. We didn't have a whole lot of industry favor, man. So to be able to step out and somebody still ask me, can I have your autograph? Man, y'all know how that feel, man. I don't think y'all know how that feel, though. Somebody tell you, oh, man, can I have your autograph? Celebrating you, huh? When the average motherfucker who know you don't even appreciate you, you know what I mean? But people who know your music and know how you stand and know how you've been representing to say, man, it'll be an honor to have your autograph. Nigga, I write bad than a motherfucker. Nigga, my shit look like chicken scratch. But I understand that them blessings are still living on. When our brother, our beloved brother, died in 2007. So if y'all haven't, go check out that interview with Beto and TOE. on Donnie Houston, another young player putting on for the South. You know what I'm saying? The Donnie Houston, cool ass Donnie. It's the Donnie Houston podcast, man. You know what I'm saying? Check out. You know, yeah, nigga. We got something. We got something down here. And also, shout out to Boss Talk. You know what I'm saying? Niggas trying to give niggas platform. Niggas trying to, you know what I'm saying? And shout out to everybody still, you know what I'm saying, rocking with Trill OGs, exposing music and brands and personality. Everybody who share my shit, everybody who go to Bandcamp, everybody who go to Trillgear.biz, everybody in this live right now, man. Hey, man, salute to yourself, man. Everybody who digging in their pocket with their hard-earned suit, keeping my channel alive, making it worthwhile, man. Man, much love to all y'all, man. So, nah. I ain't pushing no motherfucking buttons. I ain't making no motherfucking beats. I don't even know how to turn goddamn keyboard on, nigga. That nigga Beto did that, nigga. Yeah. And he being humble. Hey, y'all think he popping his shit? Nigga being humble. That nigga got all kind of producer credits from artists you wouldn't even imagine. You know, I'm talking about some major shit. You know what I mean? I ain't going to start rattling this shit off because I'm going to let him do that. I'm just glad that finally I'm not just the only one damn near online talking about from whence we came and what we were doing. Now we got some real, real certified ass shit, nigga. Platinum and nigga, them platinum and gold plaques is my platinum and gold plaques too, nigga. When that nigga win, I win, my nigga. When Bun sell 100,000 motherfucking Trill burgers, nigga, I win too, nigga. When any nigga in PA do anything, I'm talking about buzzworthy, nigga. I'm a player, nigga. I win too. Because PA really is a little bitty small motherfucker. And to have all that goddamn extraordinary G's and talent and, man, we got to salute our motherfucking self, baby. Hey, man, I appreciate you, man. We got to salute ourselves, nigga. We got motherfucking NFL players, nigga, basketball players, nigga. Hey, man, that whole 4-9 a bad little motherfucker. Yeah, they thought we were waterhead babies full of that goddamn refinery air, huh? They thought we were running around that bitch dumb with a motherfucker. Nigga, we lit. And shout out to all them niggas, all my peers, all my younger niggas opening up businesses down. Nigga, I'ma send your ass to Russ coming here on that bullshit. Any nigga coming in here cut up, I'ma send your ass to Russ. But yeah, shout out to Landlord Daiquiri Shop, man. Yeah, man. They got Landlord Daiquiri Shop in PA, man. Them boys going hammer, man. Shout out to the Humiditor motherfucking Cigar Lounge, man. You know what I'm saying? And shout out to my nigga. They gave my nigga Donnie Fault and Dante 19. Shout out to my nigga Donnie with the clothing boutique, clothing store. Shout out to my nigga Ghost with the clothing store. Shout out to the young homie Smoke with the clothing store. Shout out to Tasha with the motherfucking food trailer. Hey, man, I'm going to tell you something, nigga. It really need to be a new day for niggas to really start supporting each other. All the young artists out there, you know, my nigga Sag cooking. Nigga got them flying them plates out. My nigga Rum Tea cooking, flying them plates out. I see y'all, man. Yeah, I see y'all. I don't mean no disinfect, but let me tell you what I seen, right? Let me tell you what I seen. A collective group of very important people who low-key, they could walk by you in the grocery store and you wouldn't think twice. But over the years, what I've seen was this conglomerate of people coming together like this right here and support the fuck out of each other. And guess what? Every last one of them on top. Every last one of them on top. I'm talking about they at family functions. They at big meetings. They had big dinners. And you know what we doing? We getting our little gathering of motherfucking decon, our little bird feed, and we covering it up like I ain't got enough for you. It's a new day and age with this Trillcast shit. We got love in our heart over here. Nigga, much love to DJ Beto and T.O.E. and Donnie Houston, Kendrick Perkins, Bun B, all them PA players doing their motherfucking thing. All the young niggas rapping. All the young producers. Nigga, enjoy your journey of life and go get it. Life too short to be sitting up here being some hating niggas. Support niggas. Niggas need to come together and have a whole motherfucking ceremony for Beto, Ava Rex, quiet, laying low ass, all you niggas. Come out the woodwork, nigga. Get your flowers. If you can't get them physically, here it is virtually. You know Stack 5 shit. Here's y'all flowers virtually. You know what I mean? Bring y'all niggas ass out the woodworks and get y'all love, man. Boys be working hard and don't get no love and appreciation until they 6 feet deep. Huh? And that's a goddamn shame. You gonna wait till a nigga 6 feet deep to tell me, man, that was my nigga, man, what a fool that. I'ma hunt the fuck out of me a bitch. Brandon, I'ma hunt the fuck out of me a bitch, nigga, come to my funeral. Man, that was my nigga, man. Nigga, I'm coming tonight.
Come on, let's go.
Any bitch ass nigga at my funeral with that fake ass shit, I'm gonna be tonight. I'm gonna wait to that nigga in the dark, and I'm gonna say, Kyle! Know what I'm talking about? You know what I mean? Hey, nigga gonna have his head under his covers. I'm gonna be in that nigga ear, Kyle! Oh, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna be on a nigga ass, Jack. But yeah, man, look. Let me see what my nigga said. Nigga, this for us, nigga. Let me see. You always big OG heard from the wreck. Already, man. Yeah. Man, I sure miss them days, boy. I need some exercise bad like a motherfucker, man. Yeah, man, we got some PA shit going on, man. We got some real PA. I don't mean no disrespect, man, but this is how y'all got to be about where y'all from, man, and the people y'all fuck with, man. Y'all got to show that type of love, man. I feel bad I gave C his flowers today and used to argue with him and like, oh, nah, man, you good, man. You good, you know what I'm saying? But I missed that YMCA, man, because that was the best shape I ever stayed in before in my life. Just going there, shooting basketball, and being ready to fight, you know what I'm saying? Now, that's a crazy thing. But that was a beautiful thing. At least you would be over there fighting. You ain't had to go over there and shoot basketball and shoot. These days, niggas shoot basketball and shoot. You know what I mean? So we was blessed to be able to go shoot basketball and fight. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man, it just what it was. Shit, you want to get you some exercise, and you might have a whole motherfucking bout. Then you might have a whole bout. But one thing about it, nigga, I stayed in shape like a motherfucker. When I was doing that shit, I stayed around the 250 area, 260 area, 275. Nigga, I ain't did that shit in so goddamn long. Nigga, I'm around the 340, 360 area. Got all the way up to 380. Come on, man. I'm around here, bitch, looking like the whole motherfucking Michelin man. Nigga, I'm around here, bitch, looking like Professor Clump. You know what I mean? Yeah, Miss Pretty. Fuck with your boy, Miss Pretty. I wanted to do right here is come fool with y'all because I'm cool with y'all and show some love to my young nigga, you know what I'm saying? Beto and salute my nigga and tell anybody who ain't went seen them down in Houston interviews with my nigga, man. Y'all go check out young T.O.E. and Beto, you know what I'm saying, on the down in Houston. Hey, man, it's the down in Houston podcast. Yeah, y'all go check that shit out, man. And I appreciate everybody who be coming over here fooling me because they cool with me, man. Like I always say, we ain't even got started. Let me see. I just left the YMCA. I go every day, Jack. I got TOE going too. Wow, wow. I can't even bullshit y'all and act like I can come fool with y'all because I'm cool with y'all. Nigga, I'm out of there, nigga. I'm heavy than a motherfucker, nigga. Nigga, I might run up and down that court 2-3 times and croak. Nah, cut the shit. Nah, I ain't got it. I ain't got it. It been too goddamn long, bro. I got to lose about 100 pounds before I can do that type of shit. But that used to be the days, and I ain't going to make this video longer drawn out. I just wanted to come salute my niggas when company come. Just wanted to see who going to try to show up looking for some mess. I ain't got none. You know what I mean? All I got is love. You know what I mean? Yeah, but, hey, we got that gorillas in my trunk. Ain't nobody out basing me. Let me see if I can find some of that shit, them jamming-ass motherfucking records. Motherfucking Beto, we played this one right here. Looking like a killer, top is not double line. Cook killer, my people came to time. When we come back, when it's all in the game, taking bread off the fame. Yeah, let me play a few of these snippets right quick. Let me see what this one is. Hold on, Brandon Trillion, to come back with some more flowers. He got this whole $5. This bitch in my live trying to give me some commercials. We ain't trying to hear that. We trying to hear this right here. The wheel is in my trunk, 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 the wheel is in my trunk. Ain't no nigga out basing me, the wheel is in my trunk. Long nigga out basing me, the wheel is in my trunk, the wheel is in my trunk. Man, I'm proud, nigga. We got that PAE, nigga. The wheel is in my trunk, ain't no nigga out basing me, the wheel is in my trunk, ain't no nigga out basing me. Rolling like the pill, East Bay Trail, smoking on that old seat, got me high.
Yeah.
It come from Hawaii. I'm the MVP. Ain't nobody out basing me. I don't fuck her no more. Hey man, you know, it ain't nothing else to be said, baby. You know what I'm saying? Y'all go out there and perpetuate everything going on, because the way it's looking, man, it's just getting back started. Hey man, I'm glad God preserved me. You know what I mean? Look at me. You did. I'm glad God preserved me, because all the love and all the accolades look like it's just starting back up. Yeah. So I'm glad DJ Beto let his nuts hang and show boys what it's hitting for. And it's a bunch of more shit to come. Shout out to Ed, you know what I mean? Edgar on the boat. Shout out to Bobo Luciano, you know what I mean? Big Smokey Mitch, DJ Bird, DJ Dobie D, Bum B, all y'all, man. If I ain't say your name, I don't mean no disinfect. I'm drunk. I'm punch drunk. I'm punch drunk from hustling like a motherfucker, you know what I mean? But I ain't gonna make this video long and drawn out. I just wanted to let y'all know, man. Only way I was feeling was proud. Feeling some type of way. I sound like some bitch shit. Yeah, feeling proud in a mother. You know what I mean? Yeah, nigga. Matter of fact, nigga, I got pictures of the nigga. My nigga sent me pictures of the plaques. Let me show y'all nigga something. Nigga, let me celebrate too, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Watch this shit, nigga. Yeah, nigga. Let me celebrate too, nigga. Rap, nigga. Gold, nigga. Look at that shit, nigga. Nigga, you just don't get no shit like that, nigga, nigga, nigga. Nigga, you can't buy that shit at the mall, nigga. Nigga, you can't buy that shit at the bazaar, nigga. Platinum and shit. Nigga, you can't buy that shit nowhere, nigga. Platinum and gold, man. You can't just buy that shit like that, man. Look at this shit. Look at this shit. I ain't trying to hear money. Yeah, nigga, this major shit. This major shit, nigga. And guess what, nigga? I'm on the cover of that album, nigga. I'm on the cover of that album, nigga. You know what I mean? So we all going down in history like a motherfucker. We all going down in history like a motherfucker. And just let me say this right here. I appreciate every last one of y'all that be coming over here fooling with me, because y'all cool with me, man. You know, help me keep this algorithm going. Help me keep this channel going. You know what I'm saying? I appreciate all y'all, man. You know, it ain't easy being able to get 87,000 views and shit like that. Shit ain't easy, you know. I'm almost about to bust 100,000 views, and I ain't got a whole bunch of drama that I keep up over here. I ain't got a whole bunch of bullshit I keep up over here. I just come fool with y'all and kick it with y'all and fool with y'all because I'm cool with y'all and represent this motherfucking legacy the best way I know how. With the resources that I got. I ain't got major endorsements. I ain't got major backing. I got to flip my ones and the twos. Twos and the fours. You know what I mean? And I do that shit with a smile on my face. So salute to all my niggas out there doing their thing. I appreciate all y'all. Y'all stay up. And I'll be at y'all soon, man. Fool with me because you're cool with it. It is what it is. It's going to be what it's going to be. And it's going to do what it's going to do. Know what I'm talking about? Yeah, yo. Long little pimp. And Mama Wiz. Free young pimp. It's the Trillgear.biz, baby. I'm out.